Two are located to the sides of the stage, and four are located at the rear foot, the main floor, and balcony levels. Thank you.
Hello, and good evening, everyone. My name is Joey D'Agostino, and I'm a freshman pianist, violinist, and tenor majoring in music performance here at Furman University. On behalf of the Furman Symphony Orchestra, welcome to our concert. We are all so happy you are here, and we can't wait for you to hear the marvelous pieces we have prepared for you. This performance is slightly different than others this concert season, as it features both the Furman Symphony and has three special performances by our concerto competition winners, including Christian Cassiano, a junior on the violin, Harrison Gilbert, a junior on marimba, and Juliette Swain, a freshman on violin. The first piece on the program is the fifth movement of Lalo's Symphony Español. This piece was originally written for the violinist and composer Pablo de Sarasate, but Christian will be stepping in for Sarasate in tonight's performance. You will also hear a piece by Sarasate performed by Juliette later tonight that, as well as being one of the most emblematic pieces of violin repertoire, borrows melodies by Hungarian composer Elinor Semcene and a theme from Franz Liszt's Hungarian Rhapsody No. 13 in the rhythm of the Csirkás, a Hungarian dance featured in the last section of the piece. You will hear more information about the marimba concerto later from Professor Yersal before it is performed tonight. The movement of Lalo's Symphony Espanol you're about to hear is titled Rondo, which naturally comes from a recurring theme that also captures the spirit of Iberia. This piece starts like a display of fireworks, repeating the ignition of a common theme that is embellished virtuosically by the soloist, Christian, and goes in many different directions, always keeping a dance-like structure and character. It also features a slower middle section, reminiscent of the traditional Spanish dance called the melodania. Now, please sit back, relax, and without further ado, we hope you enjoy this incredible music.
Thank you. tonight and so honored to work with Harrison Gelder, who will be performing our next piece. He is so talented and a real go-getter of a student. In a second, he's going to perform the third movement of Emmanuel Cesarnay's Concerto for Marimba and Strings. It was commissioned by Bogdan Bakhanu in 2005 for the International Marimba Competition in Linz, Austria. It used to only be two movements, but then he filled out the typical concerto form with a first movement in 2015. The second movement is more improvisational and contemplative, but the final movement that you're about to hear is fiery and energetic and a fantastic demonstration of the marimba as a solo instrument, which it hasn't always been. Then it goes into a passionate middle section, which is an 11-8, which is a bit of an odd meter. It sounds like 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2-3. It will be much more natural than Harrison and the orchestra perform it. You will also hear, French composer Emmanuel Cesarnay is a marimba and vibraphonist as a performer. As a composer, he's very multifaceted. He composes dance music, film music, musicals, and contemporary percussion repertoire for us as well. The third movement's rhythms demonstrate his popular influences by the inclusion of the clave rhythm. The clave rhythm is nearly ubiquitous in popular music, but owes its origins to sub-Saharan Africa and Latin America. So that rhythm is... You'll hear that at both the opening and the close of the concerto. So if that sounds familiar to you, that's because it's the clave, and it's in so much of our popular music, and then it influences back into our contemporary repertoire. So if it makes you want to get up and move, that's the clave. And there will certainly be a lot of movement on the stage, and perhaps even moving your emotions in that beautiful middle section. Anyway, we'll hope that you enjoy Rythmique Énergique. Thank you.
Thank you.
next piece, Serenade, expresses Phil's interest in American folk idioms and jazz harmonies to captivate his truly unique compositional voice. Highlighting the musical contributions made by William Grant Still allows for other innovative voices to walk the path he once made. We hope you enjoy.
Good evening. I would like to ask a big round of applause again for our three folks.